Hi friends, welcome back. Very good evening. This is Ravikant, Ravi Leela. So last class we have done with what is a class, what class describes, how to access the class properties behaviors, and also we have seen the interface, what interface describes, how can we access the interface behaviors. That's what we have seen that, right? Now today I'll show you end-to-end scenario, how to work with the Selenium web driver. Okay, so if you want to work with Selenium, yes, we must have some prerequisites to download. The first is the language binding. My Selenium supports various language bindings like Java, C Sharp, Ruby, Python, JavaScript, like many language bindings my Selenium supports. Use any of the language binding, we can develop your web driver scripts. And next prerequisite is we have to download the drivers. So which browser you supposed to execute? Because once you automate the script, that script supposed to execute in many browsers. So what browser you supposed to execute? That browser driver exe files is required. Getting or not? Okay. So how you, if you want to play the audio, how the audio drivers are dependency similar to way. If you want to execute in particular browser, that browser driver exe file is required. So two prerequisites are required. One is language binding jar file, and second is the browser drivers. Where can I download these two? Yes, the official site for Selenium was the seleniumhq.org is the official site. Getting on? Yes, friends, I was giving overview. Okay, don't worry, whatever teaching now, just see what was happening. How much is the Java is impacted to work with Selenium to show you end to end. I was showing some basic idea. So click on downloads. Here, if I want to download the language binding, I want to develop my automation scripts using Java. So Selenium client web driver language bindings. Here, my Java, this is the supported version. If you want to download this, just click on download. Just click on download. It will get downloaded. This is a jar file. And next prerequisite is I require a drivers. In which browsers you supposed to execute? Chrome and Firefox, IE, whatever it was. Every browser drivers exe you need to download. Where I can download? Just above this language bindings. There are some link, is there other language exist. Just click on that, on the other languages exist. Here, third party drivers, bindings, plugins and frameworks are available in this page. We require drivers, right? Browser drivers. Okay, if you come down here, see browser drivers for Chrome. This is the driver we can download for Microsoft Edge, Firefox, Opera and Safari. If for respective browser drivers we require. So just download. I'm clicking on this Google Chrome drive. Okay, I'll click on this release link. Okay. Okay, if I click on release link, here we can see that. So for Chrome browser 79 version of Chrome, this is the drivers we go. If your version is Chrome 78, then we go with the 78 version drivers. So how do I know my Chrome, what is the version? In a vertical dot dot in a top right corner in a Chrome browser, just click on that. Click on help about Google Chrome. Then we can get the information. My Chrome is 78 version, right? 78 version supported drivers is this one, right? Just click on that. Here, Chrome driver Win32. If the people are working with the Mac, take the Chrome driver. This is the what. If people are working through Linux, take the Chrome driver with Linux 64. Even your Windows is 64 or 32 bit, only one driver exe file is there for Chrome. This is the only one. Just click on that. Yes, Chrome driver got it. Now come back. Now next I want to execute in a Firefox Mozilla Google drivers. Just click on release links. Here I was going with 0.26.0 version is there. Here if you come down, here Windows supported 64 32 bit drivers and Mac supported Firefox drivers. Linux supported 32-64 bit drivers. Mine is Windows 64 bit. I was downloading this. Yes. Now let's keep or arrange in one separate folder. Okay. Let me keep everything in a separate folder. These are the things which I have downloaded. Let's start from here. I will be creating one folder. Drivers. Okay. In this folder, I was pasting everything. All are zipped files, right? Let me extract those. Language binding Java. Right click. Extract. Extract. Now Chrome driver zip file. Extract it. Extract here. And Vico drivers. Extract it. Extract here. Extract. Okay. Let me delete these zip files. Okay. Shift delete. Now I can use this Selenium Java language binding. If I go inside, this is the client combined 3.141.59. In this is a language binding Java API jar file. It contains some built-in libraries defined by the Selenium community. We must make use that libraries in our writing a code, right? So now I want to launch a Chrome browser. I want to launch a Chrome browser. Friends, I was creating, we already having our project name as a first project. In this, in one of the package, I was creating one new class to launch a Chrome browser or Firefox browser. Okay, let's right click on a package, new class. I was giving browser launch. Okay, browser launch. Main method finish. So friends, I want to launch Chrome browser. I want to launch a Firefox browser like this. Any browser you want to open. Yes. For respective browsers, Selenium has defined some defined classes. For Chrome browser, Chrome driver class is there. For Firefox browser, Firefox driver. Internet Explorer, Internet Explorer driver. Like this. Some classes are defined by the Selenium community. Those all the classes are presented in the in this client combined jar file. Getting? If we want to call the classes, we have to configure these dependencies into my project. Agree or not? Yes. How to configure the dependencies? Yes. Right click on a project, build path, configure build path. See, by default Java libraries are there by itself once we create a Java project. Externally, we are adding some dependencies, Java language bindings. Just click on add external jars. In desktop, drivers is a folder, then Selenium Java folder, client combined 3.141.59. Don't take the source one, take this one, above one. Open. Again, click on add external jars. Go to the libs. Go to the libs. Select all the files. Open. Like this, we are adding all the dependencies of language binding Java. Click on apply and close. The best practice, it's not a mandate. If you add any dependencies to your project, make sure to refresh the project. It's a best practice. It's not a mandate. It's a best practice. Right click on project, refresh it. Okay, now we can call the classes, Chrome driver class, Firefox driver class, all these class objects we can. Okay, Chrome driver class, Firefox driver class, all class we can use. Let me show you. So you know that every jar file having its own API documentation. See, if you click on downloads, here we can we downloaded language bindings from here. We are using Java language binding. If you are downloading this, you click on download to download. Yes, the supported API documentation for language binding Java is API docs is there. If we click on that, yes, here we can see this is the API documentation for Java language binding. Okay. So if anybody asks what is a Selenium, Selenium is a web driver interface. We have to say that. Yes, Selenium is a web driver and it is an interface. Interfaces classes are presented in some packages or not? Yes, the WebDriver interface is presented in which package? Yes, org.openqa.selenium. org.openqa.selenium. In this package, my WebDriver interface is there. Just click on that. See, friends, here we can see on the interfaces, there we can see WebDriver. Getting or not? Yes, if you click on that, we can see here. WebDriver is an interface. If you say in WebDriver is interface, means what interface describes? Behaviors. What kind of behaviors? 100% abstract behaviors. Yes, my Selenium community have some abstract methods under this WebDriver interface. How many are there? 13 are there. See, close, find element, find elements, get method, get current URL, get page source, get title, get window handle, get window handles, manage, navigate, quit, switch to. These 13 abstract methods are presented under the WebDriver interface. Friends, know that 13 methods have any implementation, right? Because those are the just abstract methods. Those methods has to be get implemented in some chair class or not. Yesterday we have seen that RBI interface having two abstract methods, withdraw and deposit, where we have given implementation in ICICI class, in HDFC class. Similar way, this WebDriver interface abstract methods get implemented in all these implemented classes. Selenium committee itself has implemented some classes for respect to browser, respect to driver classes they define. For Chrome browser, Chrome driver class, Edge driver class, Firefox driver class, Internet Explorer driver, Opera driver, Safari driver. Like this, for respect to browsers, respect to driver classes, the Selenium community has defined. In these respective classes, all the 13 abstract methods of WebDriver get implemented in all these classes. Getting on it? Yes. If you want to open any Chrome browser, if you want to do any transactions, just we create an object for this class. It's a predefined class, right? Yes. Now, let's create a Chrome driver class object. So, driver reference variable equals new Chrome driver. Getting on it? So, yes. Now I can use any of the 13 methods to open the browser. Okay? Yes, here use that Chrome driver reference driver dot. See, all the 13 methods are implemented in Chrome driver class. We can see close method is there, find element is there, find elements is there, see get method is there, get current URL is there, get page source is there, get title, get window handle, get window handles, manage, navigate, quit, switch to. All 13 methods got implemented in Chrome driver class, all the classes. So we can get access that all 13 methods through any of these implemented classes while getting class object, right? So what method I use to launch application is get is a method, right? Here is expecting one parameter, that is a URL of type string type. Getting or not? Yes. Let's give double quotes https://www.amazon.in. So just save the program. Now let's try to execute my program. Yes. Will my code executes? No. Because I said startingly, if you want to play the music in your laptop, how audio drivers is dependency to execute, to install? A similar way, if you want to execute particular browser, the browser corresponding driver exe files is necessary to run the executions. See, I was opening Chrome. That's the reason drivers are not configured. Any error occurs means it caught like as an exception. What is that? java.client.illegal_state_exception. See this message. The path of the driver executable must be set by the webdriver.chrome.driver using system property. If you have more information, see in this so-and-so site is giving that. Unlatest version can be downloaded in this so and so site is giving that. So what is saying the finally conclusion? Is asking to set the driver's executable path with the web driver dot Chrome dot driver, because we are using Chrome to open right in system properties. Okay. So before creating the object for the class, we must set the driver's path. We already downloaded our drivers. Where it is? In the desktop drivers folder, Chrome driver is there. This path we have to set before initiating the class object for Chrome. So you use the method called set property. You are setting the driver's path. Set property is one of the method. That is a static method. Static methods will be called by the class name. That is a system. System is a class. System dot set property. It is expecting some two parameters, string of key and string of value. Yes, both are string types. String means should give a double quotes. Okay. So string of key and string of value. In string of key, what we have to give means, friends, we already got one error. What is that? Asking to set the path of the driver executable must be set by web driver dot Chrome dot driver. This is the key will be giving for the first argument. Everything should be lowercase. In the case of Firefox means web driver dot geeko dot driver. Internet Explorer means web driver dot IE dot driver. Web driver dot edge dot driver, like this we use the is the key like this, and value will be the path of the drivers. So we have to take the path, physical path of the drivers. So if you want to get that path of the drivers, select this file, shift the right click, then we can find the copy as a path. Normal right click we never get that copy as path. Getting or not? Copy as path is not coming with normal right click. Just shift button, right click, then only we can expect copy as path. Then you paste it here along with double quotes. It comes along with double quotes. The path is getting copied. Wherever single slash is there, please provide one more slash like this. Getting? Yes, like this. We are setting the browser drivers, initiating the Chrome driver class and navigating to the URL. Now let's try to execute. My code will execute or not? See here. See now, taking the Chrome driver a 78 version. We already downloaded 78, right? That Chrome driver version is taking and opening Chrome and navigating to the Amazon website. Getting or not? Like similar way, if you want to launch a Firefox browser, same, you have to set the driver's path for the Firefox. How? System dot set property. Here we have to give the, everything should be lowercase. Web driver dot geeko dot driver, and second argument will be the path of the Firefox drivers. Where is my Firefox then? Here it is. Shift right click on that file, copy as path, and paste it here. And wherever single slash is there, please provide one more slash. Next, to launch a Firefox browser, what is a driver class? Firefox driver, right? Yes, we have to create an object for the Firefox driver class. Driver one equals new with this reference variable, using the get method to navigate the URL, right? On Firefox. Here we give whatever you want to navigate. https://www.bestbuy.com. Save this program and now you execute this program. So first it initiates the Chrome and launches the Amazon. Next it initiates the Firefox while launching the Best Buy website. See here. Friends, I want to make you aware of how much is Java is impacted to learn Selenium. That's the, this is the whole day is the, I was telling some concepts. Okay, see, now Chrome is done. Now Firefox is opening, see, with the bestbuy.com. Getting it? Happened right? Now, one more thing, friends. Launching a browser. Okay, fine. Let me tell friends, who is the parent for this Firefox driver and Chrome driver class? Who is the parent for this? Tell me, friends, who is the parent for this Firefox and Chrome driver classes? Come on. WebDriver, right?
WebDriver.
What, friends?
WebDriver.
Yes, WebDriver is the parent for all these implemented classes. So as yesterday I shown you, object can be implemented like polymorph, implementing polymorphism concept. Interface reference variable can refer to all the implemented classes or not. Polymorphism concept I was implementing. See here, I was creating WebDriver. This WebDriver reference is referring to this Chrome here. The same WebDriver reference is referring to the Firefox driver. This is polymorphism concept or not? If you are getting object Internet Explorer, same WebDriver reference will refer to the Internet Explorer also. So one interface reference variable refers to multiple implemented classes, which is called polymorphism. Agree or not? Same, nothing is different. How we execute earlier? Earlier we created two references, but now only one reference is sharing the to here and sharing to here also, right? See here, one interface reference variable referring to multiple implemented classes. First is referring to the Chrome, next is referring to the Firefox. Chrome is done. Now same WebDriver reference is referring to the Firefox now, right? Yeah. Now one more customization. Friends, tell me, launching the, suppose I'm having 100 test cases. Every 100 test case must launch a browser or not? Without launching a browser, can I interact any web element? Friends, without launching a browser, can I interact any web element in the application?
No.
Huh? No. So we must initiate the browsers first of all, then only we can interact with any kind of web element. So which means for every 100 test cases, I need to write the same code again and again? No.
Yes.
Eliminate the repeated activity, there we form an inheritance concept. Inheritance concept means what? Yes. Acquiring one class properties behaviors into another class. Reusing the one class properties behaviors into another class is concept in the thing what we call as an inheritance. We will be writing this, all this browser launching code in one separate class, in some method. That class methods will be used in all the 100 classes, all 100 test cases. Let's try to write the code. What I will do, I will be creating one common class. That's right click on a package, new class. I was giving base test. Yes, in this base test, I was implementing some code. Okay, all the opening the browser, navigating URL, like all the methods I'll be defining in this base test. Actual test cases will be derived here. Suppose I'm having one test case is there. Let me create one more class as test case. TC_001. Okay. Yes, main method finish. In this class, in this test case one, I want to open the browser. Next, I want to navigate the URL. For that, I was giving some user-defined method names as launch. In this launch, I was giving what browser you want to launch. I was giving Chrome. And next, I want to navigate the URL. So navigate URL one method. What URL you want to navigate? Yes, I'm giving https://www.amazon.in. Friends, we are getting some errors because we just declared
return type.
We didn't give any implementation, right? We didn't give any implementation. What browser to launch? What URL to navigate? I didn't give any implementation. For that reason, it is getting the error. If any error comes in your code, friends, make habit mouse hovering on that error line. See what is saying that? The method launch of string is undefined for the type TC001. We want to implement. Yes, we have to give some implementation. Just click on the create method. And same for navigate URL also. Just create method navigate. So friends, this is a common methods. Will not place here, right? We place in where? In a base test. Base test, right? Let's give the access modifier as a public, because these methods will be used across in project anywhere. Public means can access anywhere. That's the meaning of public. Okay, now? Yeah. So maintain some valid names for parameters. So string URL means give some meaningful name as a URL, and launch means give some meaningful name as a. Here we have to write the implementation for how to, which browser you want to open and what URL you want to navigate. Okay, na? So let me create a web driver reference variable. Okay, web driver driver. Let's make this as a public, because this web driver reference I can use anywhere in this method. In this method, anywhere in the other class also I may use that. That's why in base test I was giving public static web driver. Now first of all I need to launch. For launch a browser, there is a specific standard code. We already written this browser launch. Okay, but here we have to tell that if condition, if browser dot equals, is it Chrome? Means what I need to do? I need to copy this drivers and class object creation and paste it here. When in the case of this Chrome, passing is equal to Chrome means initiate the drivers for the Chrome and create an object. If I, when calling this method, when I was passing Firefox here, it comes here, receives here. If Firefox is equal to Chrome, no. Now we have to give the else if. We are giving that. Browser dot equals Firefox. If it is equal to Firefox means what to do? I need to initiate the Firefox drivers, create an object for Firefox. See, my code is dynamic. Based on I pass the argument here, is going to be existing here, and any condition matches, that respective browser is getting open. Okay, and come to this navigating URL. So what we written the code here to navigate? Driver.get, right? Yes, here I am writing. Yes, driver.get. Here we give the difference. In this base test class, I define two behaviors. One is navigate URL, to which URL to navigate. Launch method, to which browser you want to launch. Reusable methods I created under this base test. This class, base test class, defined behaviors, navigate URL, launch, if I want to make use in any other test case. Yes, here I need to form an inheritance concept. In which class I want to use these methods? In test case 1, in test case 2, in test case 3. I can recall these base test methods into any other class or not? Yes, here in a base test, in this test 1, I was extending. Inherency represents extends keyword. Which class behaviors you want? Base test. Yes, do that. See friends, now error went off right now. Yes. Without extending that base test to this test case, I cannot call this method. See, when I was not extending earlier, we're getting some error. Where are these launch methods? It is not going, asking still to define. We already defined where in some other class. Some other class behaviors I want to make use in this class means we have to form an inheritance while giving the yes extends and what class the class will do that. So now you run this program. Now it is going to be launch a Chrome browser with the Amazon URL. See how my code was simple. Everything is Java concept. So how much is impacted you have to understand. Polymorph is a concept I have given, interface class concept you have given, inheritance concept you have used, right?
Yes.
Now, tomorrow one more test case I want to design. Yes, test case 2. Create one more class under package class. TC underscore 002. Check this main method. Finish. Friends, do I need to write a code once again in this test case 2? To launch a browser to navigate URL. No, right? So I need to call the methods launch and navigate URL. Where those methods are defined? In base test, right?
Base test.
We want to make use these methods into my test case 2. So I cannot recall that directly. Nothing is coming because we have to extend the base to this. Case 2. Now we can call the see launch asking the browser. Now I am giving the Firefox navigate URL method. Here I was giving what URL to which you want to navigate. https://www.bestbuy.com. Save this program and run this program. See friends, how simple it was. Like this. Oh, 1 second. Yeah, it started. Is initiating Firefox right now and launching the bestbuy.com. Friends, I hope everyone understood the concept. Is it?
Yes.
Friends, what about others? I'm getting sounds only from one student. What about others?
Hello,
yeah,
sir. In a single Firefox, can we open two tabs like Best Buy and both Amazon?
You want to open? Yes. Call one more time. Call one more time. Do that. What do you want to navigate? https://amazon.com. Okay. The same Firefox browser, first it opens the Best Buy. In that next call the method, in I'll get to the Amazon. Just see you. We are reusing that course. We're not hard coding anywhere. One time we established that functionality in base test. That class behaviors we are making call in our current. Oh, something is getting. Let me run once. Opening Firefox.
It's opening Best Buy and again in the same tab it's opening Amazon.
Yeah, it's opening, right? Yeah. If you want, I can show you some delay time. Let me give for your reference. I'll make you to feel you. I'll use some wait time. Don't worry, what is that? It wait for certain time. 5000 milliseconds equal to 5 seconds. 1000 milliseconds equal to 1 second. 5 seconds you want means 5000 milliseconds we have to give. Okay, see, once it navigate to Best Buy, it will wait for 5 seconds, then it will navigate to this, then you can make your feel. Okay, just a moment. Best Buy open. No, Amazon is opening. Getting or not? Right, friends? Yes.
Can't we open in two tabs?
Yes, we can do that. We can do that. Okay? That will come in our next sessions. Okay, just I'm giving outline. What is what, how to, what is the Java impacted for to learn Java? All those things I was giving end to end some picture. Okay? We can open new tabs and new window. Yes, we can do that. Okay. Fine. Friends,
okay.
I feel now my code is dynamic. My code is not dynamic. Of course, somewhat partially it was dynamic. It's because I was doing the data hard coded in my script. Friends, do I do hard coded my data in a script? No. Because the data should be stored into some external sources. The data should be stored in some external source. Like, we know that flat files, like text files, we have some Excels, XMLs, MS Access, properties files, like this various sources, external files are there, where we can organize our data in one point. From there we are accessing and we are giving to the script, right? So I will tell you one point, properties files. Properties files are seems like as a text files. .txt is like same like property files also seems like. But the data will be stored in the properties in representation to key value pairs, keys and values. Okay. Okay, let me store my all the browser types and URLs in the properties files. So we have to create one new file that type as extension .properties. Okay. If you want to create any files, yes, right click on your project, new file. Here we have to give the file, any name you can give that. What file you want to create? Suppose you want to create a Excel file, MS Excel dot XLSX. See if I create it. Done. If you want to create a some text file, right click on your project, new file, use some test.txt, text file, right? Notepad. Taken it? Any what a file you want to, that file names we can give the extension while creating. Okay. So let me delete all these things. I was creating one file called properties files. Yes, how to create a property file? Just same like how we created the file just now. Right click on your project, new file, just you data dot properties. Just click on finish button. Here, the data will be represented in properties files in a form of key value pairs. Suppose first name Ravikant, last name Leela, email address something xy at gmail.com. Like how key value pairs, a similar way the data is represented in the properties files. So I'll be storing all my browser information and URL information in a representation to key value pairs. Okay, I was giving Chrome browser as a key. I was giving Chrower equals Chrome as a value. Left side is a key, right side is a value, separating with the equal symbol. We can give equals or we can give the colon key values or we can give the space. Anything is represented as key value pairs. Left side is a key, right side is a value. By default, key is a by default string type. By default, value also string type by default. Okay. Yes, key value pairs we can represent separating with the equals, colon or space. Fine. Like this, whatever data you want to maintain, Firefox browser I was giving value as a Firefox. Okay, like this, if you want to maintain the URLs, yes, we can do that. Image on URL, I'm giving a https://www.imageon.in. Like this key value paste we are storing. In properties files, we can put comments also. Yes, if you want to put any comment, comments means that that line will not be part of the execution, right? The comment sign is the hash symbol. See, the color is different with green color, right? Comments. That line will not get executed. So I was giving URLs. Okay. So I can store in properties files key and value pair. So where I need to call these keys in my script, I will not call like this. I'll give the keys. Image on URL. In data.properties file, what is the key I have given for image on URL? Image on URL. Copy this and paste it here while calling these methods. Getting friends? Huh. Once I give the keys of Chrome browser and image on URL, it has to be get corresponding values. How can I get? How can I get that? See your friends, it was when this launch method is calling, give the control click on this launch method, taking this key browser, Chrome browser key, going inside this method, control click on that launch method. It comes to the definition. Okay, here that key is receiving here. The same key is giving here, Chrome browser key, but we exactly require key corresponding value. What is the key corresponding value? Right? Yes. So key corresponding value. Otherwise, it takes the Chrome browser as a key equal to Chroma. No, key corresponding value. So if you want to get the key corresponding value, here we have to use the properties class. Is from java.util package. Using the properties class, we can load that properties file. After loading that properties file, we can get that key corresponding value in calling that. Okay, for that, what I will do, first of all, I will be loading this data.properties. Okay, yes, for that, to load data.properties, then I will be creating one method to load that properties files. So I will be defining one method, public static void init, initializing. Okay, here I need to tell where is my properties file, where is my data.properties file. It was presented under my project, right? It was presented under my project. What I will do, yes, I will take the file path of the data.properties. How can we get this? Yes, right click on this properties. Here is the path of the data.properties. Getting on it? This is the file. First I have to copy this path. Then right here. There is one class in java.io package, file input stream. If you want to read anything from files, there is one predefined class called file input stream. Is from java.io package. That class object we have to create to initiate the properties file. Okay, yes, file input stream giving some reference variable equals new file input stream. Here input file input stream expecting one string of name must give the file name of the properties file. Right, double quotes. See, we have informed where is my properties files. One checked exception is coming. Click on add throws declaration. Fine, not okay. Fine. Next, this file we want to load it. This file we have to load it. To load that file, we use the properties class which is under java.util package. Create an object for properties class, key equals new properties. With this property class reference variable, under this class one method is the load method. Call that load. What we have to load? Our input stream object. What is our input stream object? FIS, right? In FIS only we inform that data properties file. We have to give the okay. One more checked exception is coming and close declaration. Fine. So this method has to be called for every test case starting here. Checked exception again, mouse over, add throws declaration. So once we initialize this, then only the data dot properties will get loaded, because from that loaded file only I'm using that key value pace. So here I pass the keys here, it goes inside this method, receives the key here, receives the key here. Key is equals with the value, no, key corresponding value should be equal to this value. So here what I can do, in init method we have loaded the our data properties with the property class reference variable. With this reference variable we will get the key corresponding value. Okay na? Yes. What I will do, instead of getting the key here, key corresponding value we want to get, means we have to call that p reference, p dot get property. Why it is not coming? Because any primitive variables, any class reference variables defined inside the method, means the scope will be only within that method. That's why p is not accessing outside. Getting what I'm saying? If you define any class references or any primitive variables inside the method, means the scope is only within this method. Better you define this property reference variable outside the method, like this. Public static, like this. Just create a class reference variable and create an object inside the method. Okay. Now we can use this properties reference variable anywhere in the method. Get it? If you define inside the means, the scope is within that only. That's why we are unable to access p dot. Now we can get access p dot. Control space. Get property. We have to give the string of key. String of key is what? Is the word right? So key, if you are giving key, means a key corresponding value will be retrieving. See what get property returning? String type. While giving the key, string of key as a parameter, it is returning whatever string type as a value. When give the key, key corresponding value will retrieve. See here, searches for the property with the specified key in this property list. What key we provided, with that key it is getting that property value. If the key is not found in the property list, the default property list, and its default recursively has then checked, the method returns null if the properties is not found. If the key corresponding value is not there, then gives null, right? If something value is there, means if I give key, means key corresponding value will be giving the respective value. Getting? The same thing we give here, key corresponding value is equals to 5 folks or not. Same for here also. This is the URI, right? See friends, now see here, if I run this program, first it goes to the init method, initialize my data properties and initiate the object for properties and load that data properties, that does in the init method. The next it calls the launch method, taking this Chrome browser key, goes inside this method, receives the key here. Key corresponding value you want. How can we get the key corresponding value? With property reference. That's why p dot get property of key I'm giving means key corresponding value will get. That is a Chrome, right? Chrome equal to Chrome. Yes. Initiate this. Firefox equal to Firefox. Yes, like this. And navigate the same thing. Okay. See your friends. Copying it. Now I'll do one thing. So I was using keys here, right? When I was going inside, the key is receiving here. Instead of giving the key corresponding value, if I give keys as it is, what happens? It gives null pointer.
Null.
Right? Null will be coming. See here. Once if I run this program, see what is giving? Null is there. There is no value. Just key as is, you are passing that. Chrome browser equals to Chroma. Firefox browser equals to Firefox. Is it equal? Key corresponding value you want to get, that key corresponding value equal to Chroma. The key corresponding value equal to Firefox. Like this, we have to verify. Friends, I hope everyone understood little knowledge on what I was doing today. See how much is Java is impacted. You have to understand that. The main reason of today, I taken a session for end-to-end Selenium class means today, I want to show you how much is impacted, because others people are giving less priority on Java. Because if you go to interview also, majority of the questions, 50% questions coming from Java only, believe or not.
Yes.
I have taken so many interviews in my experience, 11 years in my 11 years industry, I was taken so many interviews. What industry standards are expecting, the other institutes, what they're giving training is entirely, so much gap was there. So if they're not sounds good in technically, how can they sustain? 50% interview questions coming from core Java, 30% questions coming from the Selenium frameworks, 20% questions are coming from Selenium. Selenium is nothing but locators only, web driver scripts, and locators is the main we have to concentrate. So we'll be concentrating more on Java frameworks and Selenium for 20 hours. Java for 20 hours, Selenium for 20 hours. Okay. And DevOps tools for 10 hours. And remaining 30 hours, I'm breaking to 10, 10, 10, 3 parts. One 10 hours is the hybrid framework. One more 10 hours for the page object model approach. One more 10 hours, I was giving the BD Cucumber framework. See, we are almost 50% we are occupied with frameworks. Right? That's what. Okay?
So
we'll go as scheduled, friends. Next Monday onwards, we'll be continuing with Java. So I shown you like how much you are utilizing the Java, right? So we go on, we use so many things. All the Java OOPS concepts, we must be aware of that. Okay, friends? Any doubts in here?
Which site or reference material we should use?
Madam, your voice is very low. Please, can you please little louder?
Which site or...
No, your voice is very low, madam. I think you are far towards my thing. Since from...
No. From which site we can study? I want to ask. I'll text you one second.
So if you want me, see, this is the official site for Selenium, right? SelenumFQ.org is there, right? So don't go here and there. Everyone will copy paste from this site only. There is nothing is there. See here. Here there is a documentation is there. Everyone write their references taking the slmhq.org only. See here, documentation.
Okay.
This is the only best site. Nowadays they are given very beautiful information in this documentation. See web driver, if you click on that, all the web driver related stuff will be coming here. What is a web driver? Click on next, we can get all those things. Understanding the components, libraries, frameworks, all those things. Structure has given. See how beautiful it was. Now day by day, Selenium is getting improved. Driver requirements. Adding the executable to your path. Drivers. Getting?
Okay.
Like this.
Yes.
Browser manipulations.
Yes.
Every help is there. Wait statements. If you want to wait. We use right thread dot sleep, right? One thing.
Yes. Wait.
Like this.
5000 milliseconds.
Support class. See, so many help is there. You can go like this.
Okay,
see,
I'll check.
Every program is there with respect to supported language bindings. See here, Java supported. This is the code. If you click on Python, Python supported code is here. C sharp, Ruby, JavaScript, Kotlin, like this. Confirm, alert, prompt. See, all this help is there, madam. If we have time, we can go with this, right?
Yes, sure, sir.
Find any other best website you can go and you can watch. I simply suggest to go with this LMHQ.watch because all these persons.
If it is official, then following this, that's why I ask you that which one is the best.
See, still they are uploading. See here, page loading strategy was last update on 14th November. Okay, still they are doing some development because see, selenium.selenium.hq.org, when I was navigating, it is moving to the selenium.dev, which is still it is a development stage. They are implementing still some new things, new features. Okay, just wait for some days, we'll get the fully loaded. See, something is coming here, web elements. How to input the web elements? See, code is there.
Yes.
Everything is here only. Keywords. What are keywords? Send the keys, enter some text. Key down, you mouse the key down, key up is right. How it works, everything is given here. Mouse, still some more are getting implementing. Just wait for some more days and get the help. Okay, remote drivers, RC, all these things.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, friends, I hope everyone enjoyed today's session. So please be eager to my class. Every class is interlinked. If any class you miss, you cannot understand next class. Okay, please believe me, follow me. You definitely crack the interview. You definitely gets a good job within short time. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, from Monday, class will be from 6 to 7:30.
Exactly.
Sir, don't we have classes on weekends?
No weekends. Okay. No weekends, only weekdays. 6 to 7:30 is the batch right now is going on. Okay.
So Monday would be the same timings.
Yeah, 6 to 7:30. 6 to 7:30. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, friends, thank you very much. Have a nice day. Have a nice weekend. We'll meet, catch up on Monday, same timing, 6 p.m. IST. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a nice weekend.
Yep.
Nice day.